Good afternoon, folks. Evening, whatever.
Yeah.
And welcome to another edition of the Sports Report with my friend Gary Patterson and myself.
Yeah.
We've got an awful lot to talk about.
I'm sure we do. Actually, there's a lot going on.
And I don't know, shall we warm up on something really stupid to start?
Sure.
Okay.
That'll get us rolling.
Okay. Now, let's see here. Gary.
Got a pen.
I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16 quarterbacks.
Okay.
I want you just to briefly look through them. Don't make a big thing out of it.
Yeah.
But list the one with the highest IQ. Number one, all the way down to number 16.
Oh, my goodness. The highest IQ?
Yeah. And by the way, the highest IQ in this bunch is 156.
Okay, well, that sounds pretty high.
And the lowest is 88.
Okay, well, that's Bradshaw. No.
I don't think Bradshaw's in there.
Okay. You got quite the list. Rodgers, Roethlisberger, Favre, Cutler, Elway, Bledsoe, Marino, McNabb, Breeze, yeah. Uh-huh. Okay. Yikes. This is a tough one. And I'm a little bit biased. So I'm going to put Tom Brady number one.
Okay.
And I'm going to put probably John Elway number two. And I may go with Steve Young number three. I don't know why. And I'll go with Peyton Manning number four. And Aaron Rodgers number five. Drew Brees number six. Dan Marino number seven. Throw Bledsoe in there as eight. I forgot Aikman. I'll put him as nine. And I'll put Tebow 10. And Philip Rivers. I'll put Roethlisberger. Yeah. I'll actually put Cutler 11, as much as I hate to. Roethlisberger 12. Favre 13. Rivers 14. Donovan McNabb 15.
You missed one, but
I
that's
did.
All
okay,
right.
Well,
anyway.
You said quick.
Yeah. Okay. Well. There's some real surprises in here, let me tell you.
Okay.
First of all, number one is Eli Manning.
Okay.
Now, who?
Where are you getting this from?
From a website for high IQs.
they tested all these guys?
Well, they did. But they also, there's something realistic about this because they had some other guys in there and they said, further research has made these bogus.
Okay.
So we're throwing these up. But number one was
Eli Manning. Okay.
And you got Eli Manning number one.
Actually,
no,
Brady,
you had Tom Brady, yeah. So Eli Manning. Well, I don't know.
I don't know what I was doing.
But
might have been two. Maybe I had him two.
Okay. Eli Manning
give myself
was
credit
number
for
one. You had number two is Drew Bledsoe.
Drew Bledsoe.
By the way, Eli Manning, 156.
Wow, that's pretty good.
Drew Bledsoe, 134, was number two. Number three, Aaron Rodgers.
Really?
At 130.
Wow.
Number four, Tom Brady, 126.
Okay.
And he's tied with Steve Young.
Huh.
So you had Brady and Young both up towards the top.
Yeah.
So you're doing all right. And you had Rodgers almost in the right place, too. So number five, John Elway at 120. And you had him too, so
number
you're
two.
Close.
Yeah.
And number six, Peyton Manning at 118.
Okay.
So that surprised me because I would have thought it was the other way around. Eli sounds almost like sort of a dullard on TV.
He does.
You know? But I don't think he's got a very effusive personality.
Right, yeah. Playing the good old boy.
Yeah. number seven, I have to find Drew Brees.
Drew Brees,
yeah. Now, we got to understand something. This is an IQ of 116. Now, 90 to 110 is considered average.
Okay.
All right. And 110 to 130, I think. No, 110 to 120 is above average. And then it goes above that is gifted. And then you get to borderline genius or something
right.
like that. So 118 isn't really a lot more than ordinary.
Yeah.
Okay. But now number eight. Oh, your favorite, Jay Cutler.
Huh.
112.
112.
Yeah. Number nine, right on the money at 110, is Ben Roethlisberger.
Okay.
Number 11 is, wait a minute now. Let's see. Yeah, number nine. Okay, number 10 would be, believe it or not, Tim Tebow at 104.
Okay.
And he's in a tie, I think, with Brett Favre.
Oh, really? I didn't think Favre was going to be that high.
At both of them are at 104. Now we have the two bottom dwellers.
Yeah.
Dan Marino
apparently.
92.
Yes. Huh.
Now 90 to 110 is average.
Average, okay.
Marino just barely makes average.
Mm-hmm.
And then 12 is 88, Donovan McNabb.
Donovan McNabb.
Yeah. So I thought these things were interesting.
Yeah.
Interesting. Now, I'm going to ask you, how about the next four? Can you put them in order?
Oh, boy. I'm going to say Muhammad Ali and then Reggie Jackson, Kobe, and OJ.
Okay. Well, you got Kobe and OJ in the right places.
I do, okay.
Yeah. But Muhammad Ali was fourth with an IQ of 78.
Really?
Yeah. 89 for OJ, 114 for Kobe, and 160 for Reggie Jackson.
160 for
160.
Reggie. 160.
Yeah.
Wow.
Now.
Mr. October.
How about blasting through the rest
gosh.
Of those, and then
we'll
play sports.
I don't even know these people, for crying out loud.
Oh, Jodie Foster.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, I know.
Sharon
are,
Stone was in some movie where she was obsessed with something or other.
Yeah.
Lady Gaga is the singer.
Sure.
Janine Garofalo is sort of a comedian. Because you remember Jane Mansfield and Marilyn Monroe.
Yeah.
And Madonna. And Jill St. John was on that long-running detective show with Rock Hudson.
Uh-huh. Okay. I have no idea what's going on here. I'm going with that.
Okay. Well, this is the most interesting of all. I hope this is correct. But this is the most interesting at all. Number one, Marilyn Monroe.
I was going to say
168.
168.
Number two is no surprise to me because I've read a lot about her. And that's 166, Lady Gaga.
Yeah.
She is one sharp cookie.
She is smart.
She
yeah.
doesn't have a business advisor. She takes care of all her own business.
Is that right?
Yeah. When then you go to Jill St. John at 162. And then we get Sharon Stone at 154. Jane Mansfield at 145,
wow.
Madonna at 140, Jodie Foster at 132, and Janine Garofalo at 105.
Wow.
Yeah.
Can they play quarterback?
I thought those were interesting. Sorry we took up a lot of sports ball. That's okay. Yeah, but we had to warm up the brains.
Yeah, indeed, indeed.
Well, have you been watching the Celtics?
Indeed, I have, with great interest.
Today's Herald had the scorecard.
Yeah.
For the Celtics. Now.
Yes, I do recall seeing that. Yes.
Yeah. You know, I'm not sure that he did badly, but
I'm not sure he did great either.
No.
No, I mean, he's a little generous in a number of cases.
I think so. Yeah. So perhaps we need to do this. Avery Bradley got a B.
Yeah, and I think when he's been playing, he's absolutely been a B. Yeah. But he's
leads the team in rebounds.
And he leads the team in games missed.
Yeah. Yeah, that's
just always been his issue.
And you know what? I'm afraid he may be out for the season.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm sure they don't want to rush him, and because he is a part of the future. I hope. I think he's a good player.
That Achilles tendon stuff, though, is so tricky.
They're talking about coming back this week potentially, but they've been saying that for 3 weeks. So
look, they're winning. Why bring him back?
Yeah.
I mean, let's wait till he's gold plated and dynamite.
That's assuming they don't trade him as we sit here 2 days before the trade.
Well, no.
Yeah.
Nobody would take him. Damaged goods.
Maybe.
But do you think he's tradable now with the emergence of Smart and Rozier?
Yeah, he's not the one I would trade, but if that was what it took to get a deal done, I would trade him because on the assumption that you're going to keep that top pick that's coming up, top three players are guards, or two of the three, top players are guard. And I think you end up making that pick. And
yeah.
Now you've got a surplus of guards.
Well, that's you know what? That's all right.
I like the guards they have. I'm a Marcus Smart fan. I know this guy also graded him very high.
Yes.
But he's a defensive force.
Well, he is.
Yeah.
He's a tough dude.
He is.
If we could find him in 6 foot 9 inch
and he plays hard.
Size.
He plays hard every minute he's on the court, too.
He'd be wiping people out there.
But he's getting better.
He is getting better.
He's developing his shot.
He's hitting threes.
He's hitting free throws more consistently.
I really and truly think he's the best passer on the team.
He might be, yeah.
Boy, he makes a living finding the big guy free under the bucket.
And opposing players hate to have him guarding them.
Yes.
Because he is in their face. He's yapping.
Yeah, yapping.
Pain in the neck.
Yeah, yeah. And if you relax with the ball and show it to him, he just rips
He'll
it right out of your
it.
Hands.
Yeah.
God, I love the way he plays.
So I'm hoping that he's, as we sit here, we'll make note, it's 2 days before the trade deadline.
That's right.
A lot of rumors floating around. Like to see them do something, but it depends what it is.
I don't want to see them do anything for the sake of doing something.
Right, I agree with that.
That, to me, is dumb.
Right.
But you got to improve the team.
Right, and when I look at the team right now, they do need another scorer.
A scorer?
Yes, they do.
Yep.
And they need defense in the paint, and they need rebounding desperately.
Bingo.
So, you know, my sleeper, as we sit here 2 days before, is that they figure out how to get Andre Drummond away from Detroit. You know, the guy's sitting there averaging 15 and 14. So
those are nice numbers.
Yeah, and supposedly they're willing to listen now. Before, they weren't willing to listen on him.
Now,
we'll
the Celts have two number ones.
No.
We get their own, right?
What they have, and this is an interesting question that you raise, because they have the right to switch picks with Brooklyn. So Brooklyn gets the Celtics pick, we get Brooklyn's pick.
Okay.
However, as we sit here today waiting to make a trade, that option hasn't been exercised yet, right? Because I don't know if they're even able to exercise until the season's over.
I think it's the end of the season,
So what are you trading? You know, I mean, if you talk about Jimmy Butler, you say you give him the first pick in the draft, but there's no way Chicago is going to trade for the option, which means they then have to turn around and give up their first round pick to Brooklyn. So
and hope like hell.
Can you exercise that? I've heard nobody talk about this, so I don't really know the answer to the question.
Yeah.
But they haven't, I don't know if they have the right to actually exercise that option right now.
No, I think it's an end of the year thing. But I think
so. How do you
trade
it tomorrow?
Option, yeah.
But if you trade the option, is it still the option for the Celtics pick, or is it I think if you trade it to the Bulls.
I think it would be the right to swap.
With whoever has the option.
With Brooklyn, yeah.
So that makes it much less valuable to the Bulls. If the Bulls were going to trade us, make the trade, and go in the toilet, then they're probably bad enough right now. They could tank and end up with their own top 10 pick and then have the first pick in the draft as well. And you've got two picks in the top 10 in a very deep draft.
Yeah.
Maybe you do think about letting Jimmy Butler go with a couple of other throw-ins.
If you could be guaranteed that Brooklyn's choice would be number one
overall. Well, right now, which you can't.
But
you can be assured it'll be a top three.
Yes.
And there are the three guys that everybody's talking about.
The blue chippers.
It's kind of the top three, and then there's the rest of them who are considered deep, very deep in the draft.
Yeah.
You know, number 10 is going to be a good pick this year, supposedly, even though we're not going to know for another 3 or 4 years.
Yeah,
well, which is the problem,
yeah.
Right?
Now, he's got Al Horford here as a B.
Yeah, I think that's a fair grade.
Probably just a.
I think he adds a lot, and he adds stuff that doesn't show up in the scorecard.
Adds a lot of stuff in the dressing room.
Yeah.
A lot of experience.
Yeah.
And he's a calming sort of guy out there on the floor.
Yeah, very much.
He does the right thing.
And he's an underrated passer.
He is.
He has helped to open up Isaiah's game. I think part of Isaiah's game has been him this year.
Yeah, but we can't draft another Horford.
No.
No. We've got to find somebody that can play with his back to the basket.
Yeah.
And can rebound.
Right.
Maybe a little D, too.
A little D is very important.
Yeah.
I think the paint defense is still.
Yeah. But we can't pick another Horford because two of them, Horford is a great complementary piece. But we need a big guy that can
right.
really do it.
Right.
Yeah. I thought he nailed Jarebko at B-.
That's about right.
Yeah.
Good bench player.
Amir as a C.
Yeah.
Amir's days,
I think a C is generous.
Well, do you know what he does do, though, is he does set good picks for pick and rolls.
Yeah. But
the rest of his game
his defense and his rebounding are way below what we need.
Yeah. Not good.
You know, the major way to upgrade this team is to upgrade that position, Amir Johnson.
Right? That's right. And that's what they've got to do, is they got to draft a guy or trade for a guy.
Right.
That so that we can say, bye-bye, Amir. We loved you, but hit the bricks.
And that's where, to me, Andre Drummond comes in. Because, you know, what would it take to get Drummond? He's a 15-rebound-a-night guy. You know, he plays defense in the paint. He's not a pure scorer, but he averages 15, 16 a game. So he's a physical presence. So the guy's like 6'11", 290 pounds.
Guys that can get us the ball.
Right. And control the glass.
Yep.
What would you give up for a Drummond? You know, I wouldn't give up the Brooklyn pick this year. I might consider next year's Brooklyn pick, but.
They might not be interested in that
going
that far out.
Right.
You know. I thought he was a B- for Jay Crowder. I don't know. I like Jay, but I must admit, something's missing. He's tailed off.
I think he
in
has
the
a
last
bit,
month
yeah.
or so.
Yeah,
I'm not sure what it is.
I think he might be hurt.
You know,
he had the injury.
That's right. It could be. He had that ankle injury, and who knows?
I don't think, he doesn't look like quite the same player.
No, and he also isn't quite get the fire in his belly that he had before either. Now, I think also the league may have talked to him and said, you know, Jay, you got to calm down. Otherwise, you may be sitting a couple of games out.
And, you know, his management might have had that same discussion.
Bingo. Yeah, I think you're right. Jaylen Brown, I don't know as though I would have hung a B up there because he's been really
inconsistent.
That's right. A rookie, but he's a rookie, you know.
I really like the kid.
Oh, he's got fantastic physical.
You know, that's why all the talk about Jimmy Butler, I wonder if this kid is Jimmy Butler, but two or 3 years down the road. You look at Jimmy Butler in his first 2 years. Yeah. He wasn't the Jimmy Butler we know today.
I wouldn't be so anxious to get Jimmy Butler. We may you're absolutely right. We may have him right there.
Yeah. I mean, he is so quick. First step to the hole.
Boy,
And he gets fouled, or, you know.
Yeah. It's weird that with his jumping and all, he must have wings.
Explosive.
Yeah.
So I'd like to hang on to Jaylen Brown. Giving him B, I think, is a little generous.
I think
quite
it's
frankly.
Generous. Yeah. Yeah.
B minus, C plus.
Yeah, it's something in there. Yeah.
But knowing that that's going to.
Oof. And it's strictly because he's learning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he's they're giving him some pretty good minutes, which is good.
Yeah, started one game, got 20 points. Now, it's the harbinger of some pretty good things, I think.
I think so.
Yeah. Gerald Green, C+, who cares?
Yeah, I think even C, you know.
He's
a lot of DNPs.
Yeah, and I mean, he's like.
He's a journeyman
at this point.
Buying
a 2004 Chevy for a backup car or something.
I don't expect him to be here next year.
No, I hope he's not here.
Right.
And it's not because I don't like him or I think he's a bad guy, but I hope that they strengthen their team where he can't make the team.
You know, they got some of these kids stashed in Europe that are
have
some potential.
Yeah, he's got the, is it a Greek kid?
There's three of them
that
people are high on. A big kid,
seven-footer,
who is playing. I just read recently on all three of them. And actually,
they're
coming along. Are they ready next year? I don't know.
One of them's playing in Turkey?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's all a big mystery to me over there. Yeah.
But they're still considered pretty good prospects.
Yeah.
And two of them were first-round picks last year. So
that sounds good.
Yeah.
And yet the problem is we keep drafting these 18-year-old kids.
Well, that's what you have to do now.
Yeah, I mean, and you're waiting for 4 years to see what they're going to be.
Yeah.
How the devil do you plan long
one and
term
done? I hate the
that.
One and done.
Yeah, that stinks.
Should be two and through.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
Right. Absolutely.
Make them go for 2 years. You know, Smart went back for a second year, and it helped. It helped him. He was a much more mature player when
he
got here.
Absolutely. And you can judge what you're getting a lot better.
Right.
Kelly Olynyk as a B, there's a stretch there.
Yeah, I would give him more like a C+. He has his moments, and he can do some things, and he's actually the last couple of weeks played much better.
You know, he has that move going under the basket where he goes past the basket.
Yeah.
And kind of puts it up over his head for an easy layup. Kind of a cute move. It'll be pretty soon they're going to catch on to that, too. But he's also dumped some threes in.
Yeah, he's got the range. He's the proverbial stretch four, right? He can hit the three-point shot, but he needs to get stronger and be more of a presence on the boards. He's a seven-footer. We need rebounding.
This
he doesn't
is
get
his
it.
Contract year.
Yeah.
He needs
to be in the weight room, too.
Yes. I would suspect that, you know, if the Celtics were looking to move somebody in a trade, I would say he's very tradable.
As a package, part of a package, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know, as part of a package.
Yeah.
Depending on, you know.
Yeah, because I don't think the Celtics are going to break their necks to re-sign him. Unless he has one heck of a rest of the season.
Right, well, I think they have an option or something, right?
Yeah, I think
this is
too.
His third year, fourth year?
I think
he was a first-round pick, so I think they got 4 years plus an option.
Terry Rozier shows signs. And by the way, that C+ that he's hanging with right there, that's what Jaylen Brown should have been.
Yeah.
Two C+. Because they're just kids. They're just developing.
And you see flashes.
That's right.
And you say, wow, if they could do that consistently. Yep. But you know, there's 100 players in the league you say that about.
That's exactly
and 10
right.
or 15 of them end up actually doing it.
A. He nailed them both.
Isaiah Thomas and Marcus, yeah. Yeah, Marcus, I don't know if I'd give him an A.
A minus?
A minus, B plus.
Okay.
I mean, you know, defensively, I'd give him an A. Absolutely, I'd give him an A defensively.
Yeah, a couple of A's.
Offensively, he's improving. He's getting better. But to me, to grade him overall an A, I think is a little aggressive. I'm okay with Isaiah getting an A, 29 points a game.
I mean, he's getting it done. Yeah.
But even that, I love Isaiah like everybody else. But he is he's a defensive liability, not a great defensive player. He's actually a defensive liability.
You're absolutely right. I mean, a guy like Evan Turner can take him into the hole, and there's not a bloody thing Isaiah can do about it. By the way, the Celtics miss Evan Turner.
They do, actually.
He brought. his brand of offense in there. They missed that.
And that's, you know, one of the guys that they're supposedly looking at in the trade, a guy from, is it Phoenix? I had never heard of the guy. PJ somebody?
Something.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of his thing.
Yeah, so, yeah.
Turner was huge off the bench for them last
year.
He
sure was.
And he played pretty good defense, too.
Yeah. But now, we can't get him back, not at 18 well, mil a year.
And he, so far, is viewed as an underachiever.
Oh, is he ever?
He's struggling to get on the court.
I don't want to say he's stinking the joint out, he's but damn close to it.
Pretty much stinking the joint out. Yeah. He would probably love to be back here, but it's not
James Young, C+. I don't see that.
That's awfully generous, too. Yeah. I'd almost give him an incomplete.
Yeah, exactly right.
Yeah. You know, he's played a little bit more with the injuries, but C+ is awfully generous.
Tyler Zella, C+. What else are you going to say?
Give him a C.
I don't know.
He's another guy who has his moments. He hustles.
That's right.
He hustles.
Against certain teams and certain players, he can get do some good things for you.
Yeah. You're right. He's a matchup guy.
Yeah. Coaching, A.
Yeah, I love Brad Stevens. I don't know if I'd give him an A. I mean, I think the team still needs to improve defensively. If they go into the playoffs playing defense like they are right now, it's going to be a short
journey. You know, I loved basketball back in the 50s and 60s and the 70s. But this three-point madness.
Yeah, nobody shoots more than the Celtics. No. It's unbelievable.
Well, they're the fourth in the league with threes.
Yeah.
Out of, 30-something teams?
Yeah.
So they bomb.
That's the current model of the league.
He's a big proponent of the threes.
Yeah.
If you're open, take the three. And I think management incomplete. That's a real cop-out on the – who is this, Harris that wrote this article? Mark Murphy, whoever he is.
Yeah.
I mean, give me a break, incomplete.
Yeah.
I mean, Danny's done very good job. When you consider where he's done a good job rebuilding this team.
Piece by piece.
Yeah.
Got a ways to go.
And he said it's going to take a while.
Right.
Because we tore the house down.
But they've got a ton of future draft picks.
Yeah.
I mean, not just the Brooklyn picks.
Yeah.
They've got a Memphis pick. They've got a Clippers pick. They've got their own picks, of course. But plus, he's got a bunch of second rounders.
But you know what happens with a deal like this? Is that the people around the league say, he's got a bunch of picks to sell, but I ain't buying them until the price comes down.
Yeah. Well, it's interesting because picks are, in different years, are more valuable or not.
Sure.
I mean, a couple of years ago, he tried desperately to move up to get Brandon Ingram.
Yeah. Couldn't do it.
He only needed to move up, three or four spots?
Yeah.
Couldn't do it.
Yeah. And, it all depends on the depth of the pool of players coming into the league. It also depends on your needs.
Right.
I mean, if you're looking for power forward, and the best power forward is number 11,
right?
Well, you know, then it's very difficult, it seems to me.
So that, you know, the big question is, what are you going to do with the pick? Assume they have the best odds of anybody of it being the number one pick. You know, they're going to finish in the number one spot. There's no question. It's a six-game lead or something already. So, you know, how valuable is that pick?
That's right.
Because they're talking about these top three guys. Yes, they're guards. Yes, we have guards. But they're talking about these guys being franchise all-star, perennial all-star,
exactly.
Kyrie Irving type players.
Yeah.
So if you have a chance to get one of those guys, do you wait and do it?
Well, as my example, you know, if you're looking for power forward and the best guy is at 9, you're not going to overpay to get a 1 or a 2 from Danny.
Yeah.
To pick a guy that's slotted 9.
Yeah. So Danny needs, I think it's the kid from Washington, the guard.
Mm-hmm.
Danny needs the league to fall in love with that kid. And they are rapidly. I mean, everybody's pretty much saying he's the number one pick now. That kid needs to finish strong, and then, you know, the value of that pick will go up. So, you know, I don't think it's going to happen at the trade deadline. I still think there's a chance he trades that pick before the draft.
Mm-hmm.
But he's going to be looking at getting, you know, a top 10 or 15 player for that pick.
Yeah. Well,
So
I tell you what, I think that unless they tighten up the defense,
yeah,
and unless Jay Crowder's injury goes away, and unless they get Avery Bradley back, I think there's a limit to how far these guys are going to go.
Oh, yeah. But they need to win a playoff round this year.
Oh, that would be great.
And I think they're, as we sit here 2 days before the deadline, I think they're going to make a move. I don't think they're going to make the big blockbuster move. You know, there's talk of getting Bogut in here, who doesn't excite me, but the guy rebounds.
He's 31, 32 years old.
And he rebounds. The one thing he does is rebound.
Yeah, I can't shoot.
And we could use that about now. So I think it's going to be something along that line.
And he's on the last year of his contract.
You know, could they go big and try to get an Andre Drummond? It's possible. They're supposedly willing to take, discuss him.
Yeah.
You know, well, I would trade picks that weren't the Brooklyn picks for that guy in a second.
Yeah, not the Brooklyn.
And they have a lot of other picks.
Well, they do.
And maybe you include a Kelly Olynyk.
There you go.
A Terry
there
Rozier.
You go. Yeah. Because we need the rebounding. That's just, but that's just part of it. We need a couple other things to fall
into
place.
And that defense
in
the paint, yeah.
Bob Ryan wrote a very interesting column about the great football teams. Oh, the old Chicago Bears, the Cleveland Browns, the Green Bay Packers. And it was very, I enjoyed reading it. It was great. All those old names.
Sure. That we remember.
Yeah, yeah. Miami Dolphins, 70 to 85.
Yeah.
Quarterback names like Bob Greasy, Earl Morrill, and Dan Marino. Can't forget Larry Zonker and Jim Kick either.
Absolutely. Mercury Morris.
That's what I wrote in. Mercury Morris. I mean, come on.
Yeah.
Mercury Morris opened up the field for that inside running.
He certainly did.
Boy, you couldn't cheat inside with Mercury Morris in the backfield.
Absolutely not.
Boy, he was a weapon for a while.
Yeah. You know, Zonka was the bull, and Kick was, kind of the off-speed. And then Morris came in with that speed.
And Kick was a good blocker.
Yeah, and Kick was a good blocker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, so I get a bunch of remarks.
Okay.
Kevin Love, average 20 points, 11 rebounds, and now he's out for 6 to 8 weeks.
Yeah.
Now, there was a rumor going around, hot and heavy, that the Celtics would have loved to have gotten Kevin Love. I don't think Kevin Love exactly was in love with the idea of coming to Boston. But wouldn't that have been the answer to a mother's prayer?
Wow. Well, I don't know. Kevin Love, I think Danny had a bromance with Kevin Love a few years ago, but I think he's moved on beyond Kevin Love.
Well, I'll tell you that.
And I would too.
11 rebounds a game.
Yeah. And he's a player.
And he can play. And he can shoot.
Again, what do you got to give up?
Well, then again, too, he's a little mercurial.
Yeah, and he's a bit brittle.
Yeah, there's a little bit of prima donna there.
His best days may be behind him.
I think you're right.
Yeah.
Celtics, fourth in the league with three-pointers, with 670.
Yeah, they shoot a lot of them.
They are bombing.
But they're not fourth in the league in percentage made. I think they're much lower than that, right?
They are.
Yeah.
Jaylen Brown, future great. The tweeners, Kelly Olynyk and Johnson, Jarebko, Zella, and Mickey. Yeah, that's pretty much what we talked about, isn't
it? Yeah.
The core is Crowder, Thomas, Bradley, Smart, and Horford.
At this point, yeah.
Yeah. They need rebounding, scorer, and a three-pointer. I guess we pretty much had that all scored.
Yeah, and I hope, and the thing is, that defense in the paint and rebounding, is you should be able to get that. You can't get that superstar or whatever, but to get somebody who can help out, and, I think it's worth it to make him, if it's not a Brooklyn pick and it's not a core player, then you need to try to do something there. Because if you get a player there who, is average to above average, you can think about getting maybe to the Eastern Conference Finals.
When your best rebounder is a 6'3" guard.
Who's injured.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, gee whiz. I get just an off-the-wall thing here in third place on my list. Patrick Lane, the Winnipeg Jets' number one choice, has his third hat trick of the year, now has 26 goals.
Wow. What a talent, huh?
More than any Bruin.
Huh.
Old friend Blake Wheeler has 17. Well, we had no place to play him.
Yeah, he didn't fit.
Connor McDavid leads the league in scoring with 61 points. Huh. And that's not a good team out there.
No.
Austin Matthews, the number one choice overall, has 26 goals up at Toronto. Toronto is playing six rookies. They've got Connor Brown.
Yeah.
He got, what, his 15th or 16th the other night. And finally, old friend Jimmy Vesey nailed number 14 the other night.
He's 14?
Yeah. And you know, you look at the Bruins, and they can't play the rookies.
Yeah.
But you know what? We blamed a lot of that on the late departed Claude Julien.
Yes, we did, yeah.
And my dad's name was Claude, but he didn't pronounce it Cloud. and, you know, he did. He had an aversion to the young players. There's no doubt about that.
Yeah.
Didn't want them. But, you know, thanks to Keith Gretzky and Jim Benning, they didn't have the young kids.
Right, yeah.
The drafts were nose yankers.
Yeah, they had a dry spell.
Boy,
no
they sure did.
You can't hit them all, but you got to hit some of them.
What? Just, we won't spend a lot of time on this, but.
Okay.
What are the three top selling cars or light trucks in the U.S.?
I would say the Ford F-150 truck and the Ford Fusion and the Toyota Corolla.
Well, sir, you did very poorly on this.
I did, uh-huh.
The Ford F-150 is number one. Chevy Silverado is number two.
Both trucks.
Ram, Dodge Ram truck, is number three.
Wow.
Then, after that, we have nothing but Japanese cars.
Is that right?
Yep. Toyota Camry is number four. Toyota Corolla is number five. Honda Civic is number six. Honda CR-V is number seven.
Wow.
Toyota RV4 is number eight. Honda Accord is nine. And look who snuck in the 10, the Nissan Rogue.
Ah.
Yeah. Where are the American cars?
Make America great again.
Well, the F-150 and the Chevy Silverado and the Ram truck.
We didn't build trucks.
I thought that was really interesting.
Yes, indeed.
Well, we may as well get to the legal issues here.
Okay,
I
have a legal issue?
Yep. Pats Floyd takes plea in DUI
I heard that.
Case.
Yeah.
This is something. He was sentenced to 24 days in jail, sentenced to 96 days home confinement, and will be required to wear GPS and alcohol monitoring devices during that time. He's ordered to undergo alcohol counseling and pay a $5,000 fine.
He can afford it.
They found him unresponsible at the wheel of his running car with a blood alcohol level of 0.217. Now, 0.08 is the legal limit in just about every state. Now, you wouldn't get that hammer dropped on you in Massachusetts, I'll tell
Well,
you.
He hit the category they have in Arizona for
That's
extreme.
Right.
Extreme DUI.
Yes, indeed.
With that blood alcohol.
That's
level.
Right. That tier three.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's when they really bring
they
the hammer down.
They don't mess around out there. They're a lot stronger than we are. Now, there was an article in the paper. I don't have it with me. But that they're throwing out a whole bunch of convictions in Massachusetts over the alcohol analyzer in the stations that you go in and you blow into.
Yeah.
And it's supposed to be super accurate.
Right.
Well, I don't know how accurate it is, but the big bitch is that the average patrolman who is charged with maintaining this machine and calibrating it is not qualified. That is how the judge ruled, and he threw it out. Well, with that said and done,
yes,
I must relate a story to you about my days on the Walpole Police Department when I worked down there part-time for them driving the ambulance. The way it worked down there, you said, blow into this, and a needle went up, and it stopped. Well, you put a semi-transparent piece of paper, it was moon-shaped, half-moon-shaped, over the dial. Then you had a cursor that had like ink powder on it. So you took the cursor and you brought it up, you put it over this, pressed down, and bingo, you got the impression of where it was on the scale.
Okay.
So I was watching the guys one night because they always like to have a witness. And if I was there,
yeah, it makes sense.
Bill, come on in and watch this, you know. Well, they had a kid they didn't like.
Okay.
Got this one figured out in advance? Yeah. You put the cursor any goddamn place you want.
like the butcher with the thumb on the scale, right?
That's it. And the cop said, he winked at me and went, way past where it was supposed to be. Boom. And that was it.
No kidding. Yeah.
Yep.
Stay on the side of your local police.
And one night I was down there. And I was upstairs reading, and the cop yelled at me. He says, Billy, come down here. I want you to witness this. I'm going to test this guy again.
Okay.
He was an insurance man from Walpole. You would swear he was as sober as a judge. Blew a .37.
Holy mackerel.
Professional alcoholic.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Every day.
I was going to say, that guy... wasn't his first time drinking.
Ooh, boy. And you know what? When it was over, the cop said, okay, I've got to put you in the can. I said, okay, sir, sure, I understand. Yeah, no problems. Cop, he walked a straight line right into the cell.
Yeah.
Woo! Afterwards, he says to me, that's the highest I have ever seen.
A new personal record?
Brian Daboll has...
Brian Daboll, you didn't
left
jump.
The big tent up there and has headed down to Alabama.
Down to coach with Nick.
Yeah, that's not going to hurt his career.
It's all in the family. Yeah.
That's not going to hurt his career at all. Get down there and coach with Nick for 3 years, and you're ready to get back in the big league again.
Either the big leagues or take over a major college franchise.
Yes, indeed.
Yes.
Although, I get the numbers, too, of the coach salaries in college football. Yeah. They're astounding.
Big money.
Whew. Is it ever. Now, Darrell Revis apparently has found himself in a mess.
He has.
And he feared for his safety is why he had to attack those guys that were milling around him. But he's been arrested and faces counts of aggravated assault, robbery, conspiracy to commit aggravated assault, and terroristic threats.
Of all things, yes.
Yeah, he must have gone completely wacko over this cell phone business.
Yeah, it's unclear still exactly what happened there.
Yeah, there's a lot of... And you know, I watch some of the cop shows on TV. This is one of them I really like, 48 Hours.
Yeah.
Because I write down a lot of the stories. I'm going to make it part of one of my harangues coming up about... people kill people for $20.
Oh, yeah.
$18. $4.
Happens all the time, unfortunately.
Yeah.
As ridiculous as it sounds.
It is.
Yeah.
Former quarterback. Wait a minute now. Revis grabbed the phone and tried to delete what was on there. And then two other men joined in and two men claimed they were punched and knocked out by Rivas.
Yeah, I saw the TMZ video of those guys laying in the street.
Yeah. I'm sure they were upstanding citizens.
I'm sure they were. no doubt about it. So, you know, I think that this paves the way for Rivas to come back to New England. You know, somebody's going to overpay Logan Ryan. He's going to be gone.
We rehabilitate them.
Right? Jets are going to supposedly release him.
Yep.
And they can release him.
Yes.
Get some of their money back because of the morals clause.
Yep.
He'll be a free agent. Why not come back here?
Sure.
And win again, because we'll have an opening, because I think Logan Ryan is not going
to
be back.
We won't have to overpay him either.
No, he'll come back for a minimum and some incentives.
Two dimes and a nickel.
Well, yeah, some incentives.
Yeah. Former Patriots cornerback Leonard Myers died at the age of 38 after a battle with cancer.
Yeah, I heard
he
that.
Was on the 2001 Super Bowl championship team. Played in 15 games with the Pats and totaled 17 tackles. I don't remember.
I remember him.
Okay.
He wasn't here long, but he was on that team. And, you know, it's a shame.
Well, I have two more criminals here, if you can handle this.
Yeah, there's plenty to choose from.
This one is my favorite. Okay, now I don't ever want to hear you or see you doing this kind of stuff.
Okay.
Police in Woodburn, Oregon, say they have arrested former NFL player Stanley Wilson II after he tried to force his way into an Oregon home and then took his clothes off. Police say the former Detroit Lions cornerback had been shot by a homeowner in June in a similar incident in Portland and was arrested in January when he was found naked outside a residence in Portland.
Huh.
Do you suspect that drugs might be involved?
Well, that'd probably be the first thing they tested for.
That would probably be the first thing that we figured on.
I would hope they are.
Yep. And here's another one here. You know what? When you see guys that have good ability and they waste it, it's a sin.
Yeah.
A former Syracuse University football player has been sentenced to 10 years in prison for the stabbing attack on two of his former teammates last year in Syracuse.
Hmm.
The Post Standard reports Nacian Howard was sentenced for the April 2016 attack on Chauncey Sissom and Corey Winfield at a party.
Huh.
He had been dismissed from the team in 2014. So this obviously is not his first scrape with the law.
I think we see a pattern developing.
Yeah. But here's a kid playing on a big-time football
program.
Yeah. Who knows what? And he does this stuff.
Yeah, well.
Oh, boy.
It's not unprecedented.
No. Now, I get some sad news for you.
Okay.
George the Animal Steele passed away at the age of 79. Imagine that, folks. Now, I can tell you just a little bit about him.
Okay.
He dealt with Crohn's disease for several years, sporting a bald head, hairy back, and a green tongue. He was famous for his move of sinking his teeth into the turnbuckle pads. Mr. Steele was once a Detroit area high school teacher and coach who received a master's degree from Central Michigan.
Huh.
And he acted, you know, like
George Animal Steele.
Talk about a turnabout.
That was his character.
Brady maintains motivation. Have you read his motivational?
No, I have not, actually.
Well, I'm going to tell you about him. He has got a card. Now, this is a fellow that came up with these, Dr. Kent Keith, his paradoxical commandments. And Brady has put them on laminated, like, bookmarks, perhaps, with the Patriots logo, and he gives them out to people.
Huh.
People are often unreasonable, irrational, and self-centered. Forgive them anyway. If you are kind, people may accuse you of selfish, ulterior motives. Be kind anyway. If you are successful, you will win some unfaithful friends and some genuine enemies. Succeed anyway. If you are honest and sincere, people may deceive you. Be honest and sincere anyway. What you spend years creating, others could destroy overnight. Create anyway. If you find serenity and happiness, some may be jealous. Be happy anyway. The good you do today will often be forgotten. Do good anyway. Give the best you have, and it will never be enough. Give your best anyway. In the final analysis, it's between you and God. It was never between you and them anyway.
Huh. That's profound, yeah.
It is really outstanding. Susie's going to retype this onto some cardstock, and we're going to make some bookmarks.
Oh, nice.
And pass them out up to the senior center and maybe put a couple of other places too.
Nice.
But these are great words to live by.
Yeah.
Boy, I'll tell you. Well, now we'll get some subjects.
Okay.
Claude Julien.
Yeah.
5 years, $25 million plus they pay the Canadians. Didn't have to pay him the rest of this year. The Bruins did.
Right.
But they said, that's fine, we'll pay him anyway.
We'll pay him anyway.
Yep, because you guys were good enough to give us permission to talk to him.
Yeah.
Do you believe that?
Yeah, well, they love him, obviously. And, you know, Claude's a good coach. His time was up here. It was over here. He did his time.
Yep. And he's
it was time
also
to move on.
A Francophile. They've never had a coach in Montreal that wasn't a Francophile.
Yeah, well, that's
and that's
true.
That is really important up there that you be bilingual.
It is, yeah.
Yeah. Jerry Remy.
Mm-hmm.
The cancer has reappeared.
That's what I understand. It's too bad. Yeah.
It is bad. That's about his fourth reappearance, I think.
I'm not sure of the number, but it's sad to hear.
It is sad to hear.
Yeah.
Because he's the best thing those telecasts have going for them.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. I mean, I like the Yak.
Yeah, I love the Yak.
But the rest of them, you can have them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree with that.
Hightower and Bennett, are they tag material? Do we have to tag them?
I don't think so.
No.
I just don't think Bill will do it.
No.
You know.
Erod, Stephen Wright, and Drew Pomeranz. Those three major league question marks.
Yeah.
You know, are they going to be healthy enough? You know, they were talking about Stephen Wright. He threw yesterday. Drew Pomeranz threw yesterday. And it was like, yeah, don't talk to me about Erod.
Yeah, we'll see what happens.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, these things have a way of working themselves
they
out.
They do.
People,
yeah.
you need a rotation. If you want to be the serious contender that they are, you need a 7-deep rotation.
Yep. Yep.
And it might mean that you got a couple guys that you don't know quite what to do with coming out of camp. In Pomeranz's case, I think he ends up in the bullpen probably as a lefty because our lefty relief is mediocre. So it'll. I'm not worried about it.
I think in Bruce Cassidy, I don't think the Bruins are going to have too much of a talent search for their next coach.
No, I think they should make it permanent.
He's got it nailed.
Yeah, I think they should make it permanent.
He's Donnie. It's a big body.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tim Raines, Ivan Rodriguez, and Jeff Bagwell.
Mm-hmm.
Is that a good induction into the Hall of Fame? Are these guys, am I crazy, or are these guys just marginal? I'm not altogether. Jeff Bagwell's got some great numbers.
Jeff Bagwell had some really good numbers.
Ivan Rodriguez was the best defensive catcher of his time.
Of his time.
Tim Raines was a great base dealer.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's though.
I think Reigns is, of the three, I would probably eliminate Reigns first. And I liked Reigns as a player.
Yeah.
Although he never really lived up to his full potential. A lot of that was drug related.
Yeah.
And he had a drug problem.
Yeah. DH market dries up. Trumbo, 3 years, $37.5 million.
Yeah.
He hit 47 home runs last year. Encarnacion, 3 years, $60 million. $20 million a year. He had 42 home runs and 127 ribbies last year. Kendrys Morales batted 263. He got 3 years, $33 million. He had 30 home runs and 93 RBIs.
Yeah.
Are teams beginning to think about rotating the other players through
the DH? Yeah,
I think
so. I think the DH is...
And that way they can carry a genuine player.
Right. I think that is... Yeah. That is the thinking. And we may see that some of that here this year.
By the way, if you were the owner of the Detroit Tigers, would you enjoy paying Justin Verlander $28 million per year for the next 3 years?
A lot of money.
And Martin versus McQuaid. Was that one great fight or what?
Yeah, knock him down, drag him out. Yeah.
I watched that one on EEI.com.
Yeah.
I watched that about four times.
Yeah, I was gonna say, that'll be in the highlight films for a while.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Now, I got a couple more names here as we play out the string. Matt Dominguez, non-roster invitee. Is he ticketed? He's ticketed to protect
him. I would think so, yeah.
Alan Craig, quote, now this is from the top. Dombrowski, we've got to figure this guy out. Whoa.
3 years later.
Ruzne Castillo really looks good. He has his family with him now. He's settled down. Well, that's the answer to everything. And Hector Velasquez, purchased from Campeche of the Mexican League. He's a 28-year-old right-hander that throws in the high 80s, and he has a splitter.
Could be a batting practice pitcher, Bill.
And to look forward to next time, I've got all the odds.
Okay, for
from
what?
From Bovado for next year's Super Bowl.
Okay.
The 2017 World Series, the 2017 American League pennant, and the 2017 National League pennant.
That gives us something to look forward to.
That's it. And
spring around the corner.
That's it. Spring is sprung.
Yep.
Folks, guess what? We've run the gamut. I hope you enjoyed us palavering here.
Yeah.
And we look forward next time to visiting with you again. I already tipped my hand as to what we're going to talk about.
Okay, we
will. But I'm pretty sure it's going to be the Red Sox. And there'll probably be some Patriots stuff in there.
I'm sure there will by then, yeah.
Yeah, and if the Bruins continue to improve, maybe we'll talk about them too. By the way,
and the big Celtics trade.
And the Yankees fighting over relief pitchers.
Yeah.
I have some thoughts on that. Anyway, folks, good night.
Good night.